Hello guys, let's implement one more function, which is swap function, to swap two integer values. So here I will pass two variables to swap function, one is a and other is b. I will accept these variables in main function. So in main function, let me declare a and b and scan the values for a and b. So here I will say print enter two integers. Scanf %d%d, comma ampersand a comma ampersand b, and after that I will pass these values to swap function. So as I told you, this method is call by value. Now what I want to interchange the values of a and b in the swap function definition. So here I will declare one temp variable, then I will say temp equals to a, a equals to b, and b equals to temp. So using third variable, I am swapping the values, and I will print the values of a and b here. So printf a equals to %d and b equals to %d comma a comma b. Let me compile and run this code. Name of the file is swap.c. So gcc swap.c hyphen o executable is swap dot slash swap. Enter two integers 34, 56. It is interchanging the values 56 and 34. They are coming into the reverse order. Now this code is syntactically correct, or it is running, so this is a correct code, but ideally you should perform the console IO operations in the main function for any application. Now console IO means console input and console output. So console input means scanf, taking values from the user is console input, so that should be done in main function. And console output means printf, so printing the output onto the console should also be done in the main function. So this printf statement, it is better if I am able to write this printf here in the main function. Now if I do so, then what is happening? Let me check. When I run the code, 4568, output is 4568 only. That means I am not getting the swapped values into the output. I am getting the original values. So this is because of limitation of call by value method. Now you cannot return more than one values. If you are thinking about swapping into the swap function definition and returning the values, so for that, if you keep the return type something as integer, then you cannot return both the values, return a comma b. So if you write something like this, it will not run a compile time error as such, but it won't return both values, it will return only rightmost value. So returning value from the swap function is not the solution. So I have to keep the return type of swap function void only. But still I want this thing to work. Right now it is not working. Output is original variables. So this is the limitation of call by value method. In call by value method, changes in the formal arguments, as I told you, these a and b are called as formal arguments, are not reflected inside the actual arguments. So these a and b, they are called as actual arguments. So to overcome this limitation, we'll go for some other method, which is call by address. So that we will see sometime later. So as of now, you will remember the limitation of call by value. The limitation of call by value is changes in the formal arguments are not reflected inside the actual arguments. So I will mention over here. The limitation of call by value is changes in the formal arguments are not reflected inside actual arguments. So please subscribe to my channel. I will see you in the next video.